Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Scheme Tutorials Hub. Today I am going to start a new series on number system. In this series, you will learn about different types of number systems, conversion of one number system to another, and much more. And in today's video, you will get a brief introduction about different types of number systems along with examples. But before going to the topic, if you are new on this channel, then hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for the latest updates. If you have to define number system, then you can say it is a system of representing numbers. There are two types of number systems. The first one is non-positional number system and the second one is positional number system. In non-positional number system, as you can understand from its name, the value of a symbol does not depend on its position within the number. The Roman numeral system is an example of non-positional number system. Here I have taken the first 10 Roman numbers. Now if I take the first number, you can see that I is representing 1. Whereas if I take the fifth number, you can see that V is representing 5. 4 is represented by I followed by V, where the first symbol I is representing 1, whereas the second symbol V is representing 5. Similarly, in case of 6, the first symbol V is representing 5 and the second symbol I is representing 1. So from all of this, you can see whether you combine I and V to form 4 or swap their positions to form 6, the value of the symbol I is always 1 and the value of the symbol V is always 5. That is why the Roman numeral system is a non-positional number system. Now let's move on to the next type, that is positional number system, which is our main topic of discussion. In positional number system, the numbers are represented by a string of symbols called digits, and unlike non-positional number system, the value of each digit is dependent upon its position. The total number of digits used in a particular number system is called the base or radix. For example, if you consider the decimal number system, which we generally use in our mathematics, contains 10 digits, that is from 0 to 9. So the base of this number system is 10. Now let's talk about the different types of positional number system. For any number system, there should be at least 2 digits, which means the minimum base for a number system is 2, and hence a number system with base 1 is not possible. There are mainly 4 types of positional number system which are commonly used. They are binary number system, octal number system, decimal number system, and hexadecimal number system. In binary number system, only 2 digits, 0 and 1, are used, and hence the base of the number system is 2. For example, let's say 1010.11. The next one is octal number system. In this system, digits from 0 to 7 are used. So the total number of digits is 8, and hence the base of this system is 8. For example, let's say 217.34. Then comes decimal number system. In this system, digits from 0 to 9 are used. So the total number of digits is 10, and hence base of this number system is also 10. For example, let's say 859.72. Finally, we have hexadecimal number system. In this system, total 16 digits are used. Firstly, we have digits from 0 to 9, and for 10 to 15, alphabets capital A to F are used, where capital A denotes 10, P denotes 11, and so on. The base of this number system is 16. For example, let's say 8BA.7E. So from these four types, we can generalize one thing, that any number system with base n will have n number of digits starting from 0 to n minus 1. That's all for this video. I hope you got a clear idea about different types of number systems. If you have any doubt, then tell me in the comments. These things will be more clear in the upcoming videos when we will be doing conversions. If you find this video informative, then like and share the video. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you.